Was that you?
No, our seat just moved.
Can you go ahead and turn it off for me now?
It's scary because it sounded so much like you, it can actually mimic people's voices.
Welcome to Ghost Club Paranormal. Don't go changing that channel now, as we have one hell of a show for you. From ghouls that lurk in the dead of night, to modern day technology that is sure to blow your mind. It's the number one stop for spooky folk like you, so turn off the lights and let's get to.
I am in Maxwell, Iowa right now, very, very far from home. I am with Michael and Joey, and tonight we are going to be investigating this very creepy building behind me here. This is called the Farrar Schoolhouse. This is a very well-known haunted location in this area. There have been disembodied voices, there has been apparitions seen. The thing that I am most scared for tonight is going to be the 12-foot shadow figure. There has been speculation that this 12-foot shadow person is actually connected to an unsolved murder that happened around this area. Supposedly, he is a man who actually died just down the road here. He was found decapitated next to a cornfield. Other paranormal investigators have been in contact with a man named Terry at this location here. So you're gonna hear me say that name a lot tonight because I kinda wanna get to the bottom of it. I wanna see if we can connect with Terry. Apparently he is not a very nice man, so there could be some really dark energy surrounding this school. I am willing to investigate and get to the bottom of that one for sure. Anyway, I don't wanna talk your heads off. I just wanna get right to the investigation. I'm sure you guys are eager to see what's inside this building too, so stick around. All right, let's get to it. Have you guys ever seen a paranormal green room before? Because this is what it looks like. We are just getting set up just now. Okay, so everybody's had their caffeine at this point, so we're feeling pretty good. Cheers to a good...
To seeing the shadow man.
Oh.
Fuck my life. I need an assistant.
So Joey has set up a little sensor right here, so if there's any movement that goes in front of it, that should go off. We are making our way to the third floor right now, which is the auditorium.
How are you feeling about tonight?
I am a little bit nervous, but right now it seems kind of calm.
Yeah, the vibes now, I don't feel too much.
So Joey just set another alarm, the second alarm in this classroom right here. That's what that noise is because we're walking about and things like that. But I did just want to show you real fast over here. I don't know if you saw this, Joey, but it says remembering Terry. And Terry, this is the guy who was decapitated just not that far away from here. He is the one that is said to be the shadow figure, and the reason why he presents himself as a 12-foot shadow figure is so people would pretty much leave him alone. But as paranormal investigators, we can't just leave things alone, so...
That's true.
Yeah, so we're setting up our devices just now, and this is a very interesting room, the fact that there's a picture of him, like, right there. If the alarm does go off, I'm gonna be, like, a little bit weirded out. Did we lose Michael again? He just literally always does his own thing.
Yeah.
Doesn't it just seem so much more different than what it was when we walked through it during the day?
For sure.
Like, I feel really lost.
Yeah, me too.
Where are you? Michael. Fuck this. He's gonna scare us. He's gonna jump out. Michael! Fuck her. I was like, fuck this, I'm going for it.
I was just standing here. I've been up here, you guys. I'm like, where did they go? I thought they were right behind me.
That was scary. We're gonna try and make communication on this floor. I'm gonna bring the REM pod out and we'll see if anything happens.
Yeah, I think that we should just like, just try and be as like silent as possible. Ask some questions and see if we get, if we can hear any footsteps or see any shadow people, any children. Your REM pod. It's your REM pod.
No, it's not. It's yours over there. The second I said children, your REM pod's going off. It stopped. Are there any children here with us? Are there any children here with us? If there's any children here with us, can you do that again? Can you go up to that device that's on the floor there and make that high-pitched noise for us again? It's going off again.
And that's a temperature change.
Can you make it stop?
And then something touched it, so you see here.
Yeah. I want to go closer. I'm gonna bring my REM pod over there as well and see if we can get them both going off.
Stand up
here.
Both of them.
Oh yeah, both of them. It was the second I picked up this toy here. I went to go put it in the middle.
Well, apparently these keep
Whoa. Loud. I've never heard my REM pod do that before. I've seen it light up. I've never heard it make that noise before. Is there a child here with us right now? Terry, are you here with us right now? If you have that energy, can you please move that ball? Like a knock. So we'll head back to the stage and Joey has her. Oh.
What's that?
It was like a beep. I think it was the REM pod just went off like once.
Can you make that make noise again? Right, cue.
So this is where I was feeling that. Just that coldness come over me, so. Okay, we're gonna move somewhere else. So for the last time, we know that there was somebody up here with us. If there's still somebody up here with us, go ahead and touch that REM pod right in front of me. You've done it before, so you can do it again. There we go. It's making that noise. Perfect, thank you. Can you go ahead and turn it off for me now? So, that's so weird because I knew I felt something over there. Oh, is this the girl's bathroom you were talking about? Oh, it's spooky in there. Oh, I'm going along.
Jesus.
I am so sorry. Shin?
Yeah, around here. Yeah.
Shut up. You're kidding.
So basically, when we were talking to the owner when we first got here,
yeah.
I was feeling like on my shin, my left leg, like right in this area right here.
Yeah.
It was like a tickle.
Yeah.
And it felt like I had a bug on me and I keep on looking down and kind of like shaking it off.
And then when we got to like the little safe room, the green room,
yeah.
Michael was saying that he was feeling the exact same thing. That was when you were in the restroom. And then I had said to Michael, like, okay, let's see if Joey experiences it. And if she does experience it, then we like know that it's, there's something weird going on. So the fact that you said that,
so
on the same leg.
On purpose, so that we could just see if you experience the same thing or not.
That's weird.
Okay, so we are in the break room right now, and took a little break. I went to the restroom, and when I was in the restroom, you have to kind of go through the gymnasium, pitch dark. It's on the other side. It's in the middle of the building, but it's on the very bottom floor. Nobody's around. Michael's on the top floor and Joey is in the break room. And I swear to God, when I was in the restroom, I thought Joey walked into the restroom and I heard it sounded like you, Joey.
Yeah.
Like it genuinely did. And it was like a full sentence as well. Like, I swear, shit you not, somebody came in and went, nah, 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 nah. And it sounded exactly like that. And I just like, I started filming on my iPhone. I just heard a girl straight up talking in there. I am crapping my pants right now. I thought that was Joey that just walked into the girl's bathroom. Because I went, Joey? And I was like, nah, like you would not be going down there like trying to scare me or anything like that.
No, not right now, no.
And so I kind of freaked out. I just like basically ran upstairs. And my heart is still beating from that.
It's scary because it sounded so much like you. It can actually mimic people's voices, which really does make me feel like this is intelligent.
Yeah.
And I know that we've had a couple of hits on the REM pods, but if it can do that, yeah. It can do much more than that.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, we have regrouped. Michael had some good stuff happening upstairs when he was by himself. I had that weird experience in the girls' bathroom, so we're heading down to the girls' bathroom with a little help from my friends. Okay, I heard somebody down here when I was using the bathroom. Are you here with me now?
Find it.
You can talk when I'm by myself, but you can't talk when I have other people with me. Okay, we are back on the third floor. We figured that the third floor in the auditorium is the best place to do this because that's where we're getting the activity right off the bat when we first started investigating. Is there anybody here with us? Can you go to yes or no? Very slow, so I feel like... Were you the person who was interacting with this device here earlier?
I feel like it's almost like mimicking you. You're like, are you the one that, and it's like, are you? Are you a child?
My hand is freezing fucking cold.
Are you an adult?
So yes for adult. Perfect.
Are you Terry?
My hand, is everybody else's hand like freezing?
Yeah.
Freezing cold.
Yeah.
X? That's maybe like a no. Are you able to make this device go off next to us? And you say yes or no.
touching this.
I know. I keep moving my hands off of it too.
Yes. So you can make it go off.
So make it light up then.
Was that you?
No, our seat just moved.
That was not me, guys.
You felt that, right?
I thought that was you tapping the ground. I felt it on the ground.
That freaked me out.
Mm-hmm. That's why I'm not responding. I feel it. Is it?
Yeah.
Is it still moving?
It was like somebody jiggled
pushing
the seat.
Against it. Is that you?
No, something's pushing it again.
Okay.
I can feel it.
I felt it.
To the left.
I just felt it on my seat now. It felt like somebody just went pushed the seat in like this.
I can feel cold on the back of my neck.
Is that you? Are you here with us? I'm sure it is. I mean, that's kind of a silly question. That was weird.
It's I still feel cold on the back. Look, yeah. It's lighting up.
It's lighting up. There's a temperature, but it's weird because I'm feeling freezing. My hand is ice cold, but the REM pod is lighting up to say that there's a increase in temperature.
Yeah.
How old are you? Oh, wow, that was fast. I'm getting anxiety. My heart is racing quite. I'm for some reason, I'm just.
You want to say goodbye?
I kind of want to say goodbye. I know that this is a really short board session, but I'm feeling really, really anxious right now.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Thank you for talking to us. Well, it literally just started spinning. Okay, when the board started spinning like that, I was just going to goodbye and I felt it was just dragging. Was that you guys pulling it away or were you just trying to make it go to goodbye?
I barely had my hand on it.
I feel really anxious. I'm sorry, guys. I think I need to go back to the room.
We can go back.
Yeah, just, I just need a second.
The reason I was quiet was because I didn't want it to get aggressive.
Yeah.
Even though, I want evidence, I was just, it made me feel uneasy because of, what we felt under the chair, and I don't really know. That scared me, actually.
It literally felt like
something pushed up underneath us.
Yeah.
I don't know. It was scary.
That's why I looked at you right away, because I was like, is that you? And
no, that was no way me.
Oh my god. It is so cold. Things got a little bit crazy for a second there. I felt so anxious. My hand was shaking. I'm feeling much better now. It was right after we'd done the Ouija board session. I have no idea what that was all about. But now we are heading to the most active spot in this entire schoolhouse. So I guess you could say that we're leaving the best to last. We're heading to the boiler room. Through some spider webs. You ready for an Estes methods?
I'm ready. Nobody runs out of here without me.
Hello? Are you gonna talk?
Down.
Down. Down where?
We are down in the boiler room, so. Are you watching us right now?
It sounded like you made it.
I'm feeling a tingle in my leg.
Are you okay?
Are you touching my leg?
Hi.
Hi.
It sounded like a little girl.
How many are there down here with us right now?
Here.
Yeah, how many? Just the one? Or more?
I like it.
You like it down here?
Yeah. I heard behind you.
Behind one of the girls? Or
move up.
Move up? You want me to stand up?
You feel that? I feel like my legs are tingling.
I said that. That's what. Yeah, that's what I said. I felt like I was like literally. It felt like there was something like crawling like on my leg.
Sit down.
Was that an owl? Sit down. Oh my god. Okay.
Sit down.
Okay. What do you want to tell us? We're listening. We're here.
Lady. Get down. From there.
Get down from where?
I feel nervous.
I don't know if that's Michael saying that or the spirit.
I feel like there's like a breath.
How old are you?
It's really cold.
How old is the lady?
That's me.
The lady.
How old are you?
Thirty-six.
We don't mean to be rude.
When Michael senses something, for sure. I can tell that he's getting affected. Are you trying to affect Michael right now?
Well, it said behind you.
Did it say behind you?
It said behind you long ago, remember?
Yeah.
And he said you.
Are you
something
okay?
Something like, it felt like something like hit the back of my head. Like it.
That was a really good Estes method.
It literally felt like something, like it.
Are you okay?
Freaked me out. It just felt like something like hit the back of my head.
This is where they wanted us to be.
It said like you literally were like you're here, like huh. Welcome. Like they wanted us to come down into the boiler room.
Yeah.
Yeah, 100%.
It literally felt like somebody was standing next to me, mm-hmm. and it felt like somebody was breathing on my neck. But it was like, mm-hmm. It wasn't warm breath. It was like cold,
yeah.
like cold breath. And that was what I was feeling at first, and it felt like somebody was there. And then right at the end, it just felt like a very faint like flick or like a pebble or something like just
wow.
hit the back of my head. And
I didn't hear anything.
It did say behind you, so I think I was talking about behind Michael.
Yeah, and I could tell that you were getting affected by
yeah.
that for sure. Like at the very end there, like I could tell that you've definitely felt on edge.
It's an owl.
You know what they say about owls?
What?
Aliens.
Okay, we are back in the safe room. Like the entire experience here today has just been very, it's kind of been like a little bit of a roller coaster ride, to be honest. I was excited, then I was nervous, and then you're sad, and then you're happy, and it's just, it was definitely a little whirlwind of emotions there. I'm so ready to go back to the hotel. I know that these guys are ready to get the hell out of this place. Tomorrow, we are heading to Kansas. We are doing our next investigation. Then after that, we have one more investigation for you guys. So I guess this is like our little mini paranormal road trip. Well, anyway, I'm signing off. So if you enjoyed this episode, remember to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. And I will see yous again very, very soon.
Boy, that really was a show.